Welcome to the next part of the course, where we begin our coverage. Welcome to the next part of the course, where we begin our coverage of Project Reactor's Flux class. In this lesson, we'll be describing a number of different flux operators, beginning with its factory method operators. These methods are used to create a flux stream in various ways. And we'll be talking about the just, fromArray, fromIterable, and fromFactory methods. Let's start out by talking about the just operator. This operator creates a flux that emits the given elements and then completes. The parameters, which can be one or many, are elements to emit, and they're provided as a var args argument. This particular method returns a new flux that's captured at instantiation time. In other words, it's eager. Multiple elements can be emitted, unlike the mono just operator. Mono will just emit one element, whereas flux can emit many elements with the just operation. This factory method is commonly used to adapt non-reactive input sources into the overall reactive model. Here's a very simple example where we're going to use flux.just to pass in a bunch of big fractions. We pass in four big fractions. We could pass in one. We could pass in eight. Doesn't really matter. We're creating a flux stream from these four big fraction operators. You can find this example in the link at the bottom of the slide, and we'll be covering this example later as part of the lesson when we get to the case study. Keep in mind that just is evaluated eagerly at assembly time, just like mono just is. So what that means is it always runs in the thread where the assembly is performed. You'll also see as we get a little further along into our discussion of factory methods that the fromIterable and fromArray factory method operators also evaluate eagerly. And we'll compare and contrast that with another method later that evaluates things lazily. RxJava has an observable just method that works exactly the same way that Project Reactor's flux just method works. You can see here that here's an example that we'll also look at when we get to RxJava, where we create an observable stream from four big fraction objects, just like we did with the flux just. Interestingly enough, these factory methods are also very similar to the stream.of factory method that's part of the Java streams framework. Here again, we're using stream.of to be able to create a stream of four big fractions. Let's now turn our attention to another factory method. This one's called fromIterable. And as the name suggests, this particular method creates a flux that emits items contained in the given iterable. Interestingly enough, the iterator method will be invoked at least once and potentially at most twice for each subscriber. This doesn't really matter for built-in iterators that come with Java's collection framework, but if you make your own iterator, you have to remember that its iterator method may get called more than once. So that can be a little bit confusing at times. As with the just method, this factor method is commonly used to adapt non-reactive input sources into the reactive model. Most commonly, this is used to adapt Java collections like list or set, as we show here, where we're taking a list, which has a bunch of integers in it, and then we're creating a flux stream using that list as input. And again, we'll look at this example in just a little bit. RxJava also has a fromIterable method that works exactly the same way. You can see we have the same example from the previous slide, except now we're using observable instead of flux, and we go ahead and create an observable stream that will emit the elements that are part of that Java list. Also, there's another equivalence. If you take a look at Java streams, it has a stream method. And you can say, if you make a list, you can say list.stream. This is the canonical way of being able to create streams, especially sequential streams in Java streams framework. So very similar to fromIterable in both RxJava and Project Reactor. Let's now turn our attention to yet another factory method that's part of the flux class. This is the fromArray method. And you might assume from the name that it creates a flux that will emit items from the given built-in array. Remember that lists and built-in arrays are different types in Java. The parameter that's passed here will provide the data that's going to be used to create the flux. And what we get back is a flux that will emit the items that are part of that array. This factory method operator also adapts non-reactive input sources into the reactive model. And once again, just to illustrate how this works, we create ourselves a Java built-in array of integer, and then we go ahead and use flux.fromArray to convert that built-in array of integer into the corresponding flux stream. Similar capability exists with RxJava's fromArray method, works just like Project Reactor's fromArray method. It's also similar to the of method of Java streams. So once again, you can use the of method to give it an array, just like you can give it other data types that we saw earlier. And this will go ahead and convert that built-in array into a stream. It's also, once again, another equivalence is similar to the stream method on the Java arrays class, which is yet another way of being able to create a stream. So you can see that there's all kinds of ways of getting very similar behaviors across different types of modern Java streaming-oriented frameworks. The fourth and final factory method we're going to talk about from Flux, is the from method. And this is used to decorate the specified publisher with the Flux API. So this is just a little bit different from some of the other methods that we've talked about so far. The parameter that's passed here is the source that we want to decorate by essentially encapsulating it within a Flux. And what this does is this returns a new Flux that does the decoration at runtime. So unlike just and fromIterable and fromArray, which are all eager operations, the from method, the from operator, is lazy. And that means it's evaluated at runtime. The publisher is evaluated at runtime. And keep this in mind, by the way, when we get a little further along and we start talking about the subscribe on method and how that works, because that will have an impact in terms of when these things can run in the background and when they can't. The eager operations will always run in the assembly thread, the creation thread, where the flux is created, whereas the ones we're seeing here, like the ones that are, this one in particular, from, which is lazy, can be put in a background thread and run in a background thread. This factory method operator, like all the other ones, is used to adapt non-Flux publishers into the Flux API. This example is an interesting example. Again, we'll look at it in more detail later, but what we're doing here is we're using mono.fromCallable to make ourselves a random big fraction. And then we're using that, which is a late binding operation, to be used to create the publisher information that will then be encapsulated by flux.from. So we're creating a flux that will contain a single big fraction object from a mono. And notice that this is lazy. So what that means is that this publisher parameter that we're passing in here will be called at runtime, and therefore it could be giving back different values for each subscriber, because of course it's actually generating the big fraction randomly. So each time this is called, it'll give back a different result. And that again is different from just and from iterable and from array, which are all eager. They'll always give back the same result. One reason why this particular idiom I'm showing here is useful is it allows you to work around Flux's lack of a from callable method. There is no from callable method, no lazy from callable method that's part of the Flux API for some strange reason. In contrast, RxJava's observable method has a lazy from callable. So if you're going to use observable and RxJava, you can do the call like this with from callable. Whereas if you're trying to use something like Project Reactor, you're going to have to wrap a call to a mono from callable within a Flux from method, which is a little bit annoying. I'm not quite sure why they did that, but that's the workaround to get the same lazy binding effect. So that's the end of our discussion of factory methods for the Flux class.